Do humans perceive reality as it really is? August 19, 2019. Do humans perceive reality as it really is? Credit, Alexis Pierre-Antoine. One of the deepest problems in epistemology is how we know the nature of reality. Over the millennia, philosophers have offered many theories. From solipsism, one knows only that there is a mind to the theory that natural selection has shaped our senses to give us an accurate model of the world. Now a new theory from the University of California at Irvine. Cognitive scientist Donald Hoffman is gaining attention. Based on evolutionary psychology, it is called the Perception Interface Theory, ITP, and argues that perceptions act as a species-specific user interface, which directs behavior towards survival and reproduction rather than towards the truth. The analogy of Hoffman's computer is that physical space is like a desktop, and that objects on it are like desktop icons, which are produced by the graphical user interface GUI. Our senses, he says, form a biological user interface, a sticky GUI, between our brain and the outside world, transducing physical stimuli like photons of light into neural impulses processed by the visual cortex as things in the environment. GUIs are useful because you do not need to know what is inside computers and brains. You just need to know how to interact with the interface enough to accomplish your task. Adaptive function, not true perception, is what is important. Hoffman's holotype is the Australian beetle Ulidae morpha becquerelli. Females are large, bright, brown and dimpled. So too are the discarded beer bottles, and the males will mount them until they die of heat, hunger, or ants eaten. The species was on the brink of extinction because its senses and brains were designed by natural selection not to realize reality. It's a beer bottle, you idiot. But to mate with anything big, brown, shiny and wavy. To test his theory, Hoffman performed thousands of evolutionary computer simulations in which digital organisms whose perceptual systems are tuned exclusively for truth are surpassed by those tuned for aptitude alone. Since natural selection depends only on expected fitness, evolution has shaped our sensory systems toward more apt behavior rather than true representation. ITP deserves serious consideration and testing, but there are doubts. First, how could a more accurate perception of reality not be adaptive? Hoffman's answer is that evolution has given us an interface to hide the underlying reality because, for example, you don't need to know how neurons create images of snakes. You just need to jump out of the way of the snake icon. But how does the icon look like a snake in the first place? Natural selection. And why have some non-venomous snakes evolve to mimic poisonous species? Because predators avoid real poisonous snakes. Mimicry works only if there is an objective reality to imitate. Hoffman stated that a stone is an interface icon, not a constituent of objective reality, but a real rock, cut into an arrowhead and thrown into a four-legged meal, works even if you don't know physics and calculation. Is this not a true perception with adaptive meaning? For beetles, beer bottles are what ethologists call supernormal stimuli, which mimic objects that organisms have evolved to respond and elicit a stronger response by doing so, such as for some people silicone breast implants in women and testosterone-enhanced bodybuilding in men. Supernormal stimuli work only because evolution has designed us to respond to normal stimuli, which must be accurately portrayed by our senses for our brain to function. Hoffman says perception is species-specific and we should take predators seriously, but not literally. Yes, a dolphin's icon for hark no doubt looks different from a human, but there really are sharks, and they do have powerful tails at one end and a toothy mouth at the other end, and that's true no matter how your sensory system works. In addition, computer simulations are useful for modeling how evolution may have happened, but an actual ITP test would be to determine if most biological sensory interfaces create icons that resemble reality or distort it. The data will tell. Finally, why present this problem as a choice between fitness and truth? Adaptations depend largely on a relatively accurate model of reality. The fact that science is progressing toward, say, eradicating disease and landing spacecraft on Mars must mean that our perceptions of reality are getting closer and closer to the truth, even if it's tiny.